This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Molybdenum is a chemical element with symbol Mo and atomic number 42. The name is from Neo-Latin molybdenum, from ancient Greek molybdos molybdos, meaning lead. Since its ores were confused with lead ores, molybdenum minerals have been known throughout history, but the element was discovered in the sense of differentiating it as a new entity from the mineral salts of other metals in 1778 by Carl Wilhelm Scheele. The metal was first isolated in 1781 by Peter Jacob Hagel. Molybdenum does not occur naturally as a free metal on Earth. It is found only in various oxidation states in minerals. The free element, a silvery metal with a gray cast, has the sixth highest melting point of any element. It readily forms hard, stable carbides in alloys, and for this reason most of world production of the element, about 80%, is used in steel alloys, including high-strength alloys and superalloys. Most molybdenum compounds have low solubility in water, but when molybdenum-bearing minerals contact oxygen and water, the resulting molybdate ion Mu2-4 is quite soluble. Industrially, molybdenum compounds, about 14% of world production of the element, are used in high pressure and high temperature applications as pigments and catalysts. Molybdenum bearing enzymes are by far the most common bacterial catalysts for breaking the chemical bond in atmospheric molecular nitrogen in the process of biological nitrogen fixation. At least 50 molybdenum enzymes are now known in bacteria and animals, although only bacterial and cyanobacterial enzymes are involved in nitrogen fixation. These nitrogenases contain molybdenum in a form different from other molybdenum enzymes, which all contain fully oxidized molybdenum in a molybdenum cofactor. These various molybdenum cofactor enzymes are vital to the organisms, and molybdenum is an essential element for life in all higher eukaryote organisms, though not in all bacteria. Contents 1 characteristics 11 physical properties 12 isotopes 13 compounds and chemistry 2 history 3 occurrence and production 31 history of molybdenum mining 4 applications 41 alloys 42 other applications as the pure element 421 compounds 14% of global use 5 biological role 51 nitrogenases 52 molybdenum cofactor enzymes 53 human dietary intake and deficiency 54 related diseases 55 copper molybdenum antagonism 6 precautions 7 see also 8 references 9 external links characteristics physical properties in its pure form. Molybdenum is a silvery gray metal with a Mohs hardness of 55. It has a melting point of 2623. Approximately 50 to 100. See also, category, molybdenum compounds oxidation state example -2 Na2 Mo2 CO10 0 MoCo6 1 Na C6 H6 Mo 2 MoCl 2 3 Na3 6 4 Mos 2 5 MoCl 5 6 MoF 6 Kegan structure of the phosphomolybdate anion P3-, an example of a polyoxometallate. Molybdenum is a transition metal with an electronegativity of 216 on the Pauling scale and a standard atomic weight of 9595. Resulting in molybdenum trioxide, 2-Mo3, O22-Mu3. The trioxide is volatile and sublimes at high temperatures. This prevents formation of a continuous protective passivating oxide layer, which would stop the bulk oxidation of metal. Molybdenum has several oxidation states, the most stable being 4 and 6 bolded in the table at left. The chemistry and the compounds show more similarity to tungsten than to chromium. The instability of molybdenum-y and tungsten-y compounds, for example, contrasts with the stability of the chromium-y compounds. The highest oxidation state is seen in molybdenum V oxide Mu3, while the normal sulfur compound is molybdenum disulfide Mos2. Molybdenum V oxide is soluble in strong alkaline water, forming molybdates Mu42-. Molybdates are weaker oxidants than chromates, but they show a similar tendency to form complex oxyanions by condensation at lower pH values, such as 6- and 4- polymolybdates can incorporate other ions, forming polyoxometallates. The dark blue phosphorus containing heteropolymolybdate P3- is used for the spectroscopic detection of phosphorus. The broad range of oxidation states of molybdenum is reflected in various molybdenum chlorides. Molybdenum chloride MOCl2 yellow solid, molybdenum chloride MOCl3 dark red solid, molybdenum chloride MOCl4 black solid, molybdenum chloride MOCl5 dark green solid, molybdenum chloride MOCl6 brown solid. The structure of the MOCl2 is clusters of Mo6Cl84 and 4 chloride ions compensating the charge like chromium and some other transition metals. Molybdenum forms quadruple bonds, such as in Mo2CH3COO4. This compound can be transformed into Mo2Cl84-, which also has a quadruple bond. The oxidation state 0 is possible with carbon monoxide as ligand, such as in molybdenum hexacarbonyl, MOCO6-history molybdenite. The principal ore from which molybdenum is now extracted was previously known as molybdena. Molybdena was confused with and often utilized as though it were graphite like graphite. Molybdenite can be used to blacken a surface or as a solid lubricant. Even when molybdena was distinguishable from graphite, it was still confused with the common lead ore PbS, now called galena. The name comes from ancient Greek molybdos, molybdos, meaning lead. The Greek word itself has been proposed as a loanword from Anatolian Luvian and Lydian languages, although reportedly molybdenum was deliberately alloyed with steel in 14th century Japanese sword MFD ca. 1330. That art was never employed widely and was later lost in the West in 1754. Bengt Anderson Qvist examined a sample of molybdenite and determined that it did not contain lead and thus was not galena. By 1778, Swedish chemist Carl Wilhelm Scheele stated firmly that molybdena was indeed neither galena nor graphite. Instead, Scheele correctly proposed that molybdena was an ore of a distinct new element, named molybdenum for the mineral in which it resided, and from which it might be isolated. Peter Jacob Hegelm successfully isolated molybdenum using carbon and linseed oil in 1781. For the next century, molybdenum had no industrial use. It was relatively scarce, the pure metal was difficult to extract, and the necessary techniques of metallurgy were immature. Early molybdenum steel alloys showed great promise of increased hardness, but efforts to manufacture the alloys on a large scale were hampered with inconsistent results, a tendency toward brittleness, and recrystallization. In 1906, William D. Coolidge filed a patent for rendering molybdenum ductile, leading to applications as a heating element for high-temperature furnaces and as a support for tungsten filament light bulbs. Oxide formation and degradation require that molybdenum be physically sealed or held in an inert gas. In 1913, Frank E. Elmore developed a froth flotation process to recover molybdenite from ores. Flotation remains the primary isolation process. During the World War I, demand for molybdenum spiked. It was used both in armor plating and as a substitute for tungsten in high-speed steels. Some British tanks were protected by 75 molybdenum bearing grain 1x06. The oxidized ore is then usually extracted with aqueous ammonia to give ammonium molybdate, Mu32NH3H2O ammonium orthomolybdate H2O copper. An impurity in molybdenite is less soluble in ammonia. To completely remove it from the solution, it is precipitated with hydrogen sulfide. Ammonium molybdate converts to ammonium dimolybdate, which is isolated as a solid. Heating this solid gives molybdenum trioxide, NH42Mo2072Mu32NH3H2O. The crude trioxide can be further purified by sublimation at 1100. Traded as a commodity on the exchange. History of molybdenum mining. Historically, the Kanaben mine in southern Norway, opened in 1885, was the first dedicated molybdenum mine. It was closed from 1973 to 2007, but was reopened that year and now produces 100,000 kilograms 98 long tons, 110 short tons of molybdenum disulfide per year. Large mines in Colorado such as the Henderson mine and the Climax mine and in British Columbia yield molybdenite as their primary product, while many porphyry copper deposits such as the Bingham Canyon mine in Utah and the Chuquicamata mine in northern Chile produce molybdenum as a byproduct of copper mining applications. Alloys. A plate of molybdenum copper alloy. About 86% of molybdenum produced is used in metallurgy, with the rest used in chemical applications. The estimated global use is structural steel 35%, stainless steel 25%, chemicals 14%, tool Electrical contacts, industrial motors, and filaments. Most high-strength steel alloys, for example, 41XX steels, contain 0.25% to 8% molybdenum even in these small portions. More than 43,000 tons of molybdenum are used each year in stainless steels, tool steels, cast irons, and high-temperature superalloys. Molybdenum is also valued in steel alloys for its high corrosion resistance and weldability. Molybdenum contributes corrosion resistance to type 300 stainless steel, specifically type 316, and especially so in the so-called superaustenitic stainless steels such as alloy AL6XN, 254SMO or 1925HMO. Molybdenum increases lattice strain, thus increasing the energy required to dissolve iron atoms from the surface. Molybdenum is also used to enhance the corrosion resistance of ferritic, for example grade 444, and martensitic, for example 14122 and 14418 stainless steels, because of its lower density and more stable price. Molybdenum is sometimes used in place of tungsten. An example is the M series of high-speed steels such as M2, M4 and M42 as substitution for the T steel series, which contain tungsten. Molybdenum can also be used as a flame-resistant coating for other metals, although its melting point is 2623. That resists molten fluoride salts at temperatures above 1300. Molybdenum disulfide MOS-2 is used as a solid lubricant and a high-pressure high-temperature HPHT antiwear agent. It forms strong films on metallic surfaces and is a common additive to HPHT greases. In the event of a catastrophic grease failure, a thin layer of molybdenum prevents contact of the lubricated parts. It also has semiconducting properties with distinct advantages over traditional silicon or graphene in electronics applications. MOS-2 is also used as a catalyst in hydrocracking of petroleum fractions containing nitrogen, sulfur and oxygen. Molybdenum disilicide MOSI-2 is an electrically conducting ceramic with primary use in heating elements operating at temperatures above 1500. Molybdenum-coated soda-lime glass is used in SIG's solar cells. Phosphomolybdic acid is a stain used in thin-layer chromatography. Molybdenum-99 is a parent radioisotope of the daughter radioisotope technetium-99m, used in many medical procedures. The isotope is handled and stored as the molybdate. Biological role: nitrogenases. The most important role of molybdenum in living organisms is as a metal heteroatom at the active site in certain enzymes in bacterial nitrogen fixation. The nitrogenase enzyme involved in the terminal step of reducing molecular nitrogen usually contains molybdenum in the active site, though replacement of Mo with iron or vanadium is also known. The structure of the catalytic center of the enzyme is similar to that in iron sulfur proteins. It incorporates A and multiple MOV3S3 clusters. The reaction that nitrogenase enzymes perform is N28EO16 8H8E16ATP16H_O longriterO2NH_H_16ADP16P_. With protons and electrons from the electron transport chain, nitrogen is reduced to ammonia and free hydrogen gas. This is an energy-using process, requiring the splitting hydrolysis of ATP into ADP plus free phosphate. Pi in 2008, evidence was reported that a scarcity of molybdenum in the Earth's early oceans was a limiting factor for nearly 2 billion years in the further evolution of eukaryotic life, which includes all plants and animals. The chain of causation is as follows: the relative lack of oxygen in the early ocean resulted in a scarcity in dissolved molybdenum. Most molybdenum compounds have low solubility in water, but the molybdate ion Mu42- is soluble and forms when molybdenum-containing minerals are in contact with oxygen and water. The lack of dissolved molybdenum limited the growth of prokaryotic nitrogen fixing bacteria, which require molybdenum-bearing enzymes for the process. The lack of prokaryotic nitrogen-fixing bacteria limited the growth of ocean eukaryotes, which require oxidized nitrogen suitable for the production of organic nitrogen compounds or the organics themselves, like proteins from prokaryotic bacteria. However, once oxygen had been created in seawater by the limited eukaryotes, it reacted with water and the molybdenum in minerals on the sea bottom to produce soluble molybdate, making it available to nitrogen-fixing bacteria. Those bacteria provided fixed usable nitrogen compounds for higher forms of life. Although oxygen once promoted nitrogen fixation by making molybdenum available in water, it also directly poisons nitrogenase enzymes. Thus, in Earth's this ancient history, after oxygen arrived in large quantities in Earth's air and water, organisms that continued to fix nitrogen in aerobic conditions isolated and protected their nitrogen-fixing enzymes from too much oxygen in heterocysts or equivalent structures. This structural isolation of nitrogen fixation reactions in aerobic organisms continues to the present. The molybdenum cofactor pictured is composed of a molybdenum-free organic complex called molybdopterin, which has bound an oxidized molybdenum V atom through adjacent sulfur or occasionally selenium atoms. Except for the ancient nitrogenases, all known MO using enzymes use this cofactor. Molybdenum cofactor enzymes, though molybdenum forms compounds with various organic molecules, including carbohydrates and amino acids, it is transported throughout the human body as MU42- at least 50. Molybdenum-containing enzymes were known by 2002, mostly in bacteria, and the number is increasing with every year. Those enzymes include aldehyde oxidase, sulfite oxidase, and xanthine oxidase in some animals, and in humans, the oxidation of xanthine to uric acid, a process of purine catabolism, is catalyzed by xanthine oxidase, a molybdenum-containing enzyme. The activity of xanthine oxidase is directly proportional to the amount of molybdenum in the body. However, an extremely high concentration of molybdenum reverses the trend and can act as an inhibitor in both purine catabolism and other processes. Molybdenum concentration also affects protein synthesis, metabolism, and growth in animals and plants. A tricyclic compound called molybdopterin, which, despite the name, contains no molybdenum, is reacted with molybdate to form a complete molybdenum-containing cofactor called molybdenum cofactor. Other than the phylogenetically ancient nitrogenases discussed above that fix nitrogen in some bacteria and cyanobacteria, all molybdenum-using enzymes so far identified use the molybdenum cofactor, where molybdenum is in the oxidation state of V, similar to molybdate. Molybdenum enzymes in plants and animals catalyze the oxidation and sometimes reduction of certain small molecules in the process of regulating nitrogen, sulfur, and carbon. Human dietary intake and deficiency. Molybdenum is a trace dietary element necessary for the survival of humans and the few mammals that have been studied. Four mammalian MO-dependent enzymes are known, all of them harboring a pterin-based molybdenum cofactor MOCO in their active site: sulfite oxidase, xanthine oxidoreductase, aldehyde oxidase, and mitochondrial amidoxime reductase. People severely deficient in molybdenum have poorly functioning sulfite oxidase and are prone to toxic reactions to sulfites in foods. The human body contains about 007. Of molybdenum in tissues. Low soil concentration of molybdenum in a geographical band from northern China to Iran results in a general dietary molybdenum deficiency, and is associated with increased rates of esophageal cancer compared to the United States, which has a greater supply of molybdenum in the soil. People living in those areas have about 16 times greater risk for esophageal squamous cell carcinoma. Molybdenum deficiency has also been reported as a consequence of non-molybdenum supplemented total parenteral nutrition. Complete intravenous feeding for long periods of time, it results in high blood levels of sulfite and urate, in much the same way as molybdenum cofactor deficiency. However, presumably since pure molybdenum deficiency from this cause occurs primarily in adults, the neurological consequences are not as marked as in cases of congenital cofactor deficiency related diseases. A congenital molybdenum cofactor deficiency disease, seen in infants, is an inability to synthesize molybdenum cofactor, a heterocyclic molecule that binds molybdenum at the active site in all known human enzymes that use molybdenum. The resulting deficiency results in high levels of sulfite and urate, and neurological damage. Copper molybdenum antagonism. High levels of molybdenum can interfere with the body's uptake of copper, producing copper deficiency. Molybdenum prevents plasma proteins from binding to copper, and it also increases the amount of copper that is excreted in urine. Ruminants that consume high levels of molybdenum suffer from diarrhea, stunted growth, anemia, and achromotrichia, loss of fur pigment. These symptoms can be alleviated by copper supplements, either dietary and injection. The effective copper deficiency can be aggravated by excess sulfur. Copper reduction or deficiency can also be deliberately induced for therapeutic purposes by the compound ammonium tetrathiomolybdate, in which the bright red anion tetrathiomolybdate is the copper chelating agent. Tetrathiomolybdate was first used therapeutically in the treatment of copper toxicosis in animals. It was then introduced as a treatment in Wilson's disease, a hereditary copper metabolism disorder in humans. It acts both by competing with copper absorption in the bowel and by increasing excretion. It has also been found to have an inhibitory effect on angiogenesis. angiogenesis, potentially by inhibiting the membrane translocation process that is dependent on copper ions. This is a promising avenue for investigation of treatments for cancer, age-related macular degeneration, and other diseases that involve a pathologic proliferation of blood vessels. Precautions: molybdenum dusts and fumes, generated by mining or metalworking, can be toxic, especially if ingested, including dust trapped in the sinuses and later swallowed. Low levels of prolonged exposure can cause irritation to the eyes and skin. Direct inhalation or ingestion of molybdenum and its oxides should be avoided. OSHA regulations specify the maximum permissible molybdenum exposure in an 8-hour day as 5. ISBN. Engineering News, retrieved 7 July 2009. Edition 30-34, DOI 101002, ANI 199100341. Selbin Erde, Svenska Vetenska Katamhandlingar 49-268. 40 Panama Canals in 1 year. Popular Science 61. Drainage Basin, Norway 1. Evaluation of overbank sediments as sampling medium for regional geochemical mapping. Journal of Geochemical Exploration 58-2-3-157, DOI 101016, S0375674296-00069-6. Carrot, Lal, S. Pottle, R.S. 2001, Monitoring of Atmospheric Behavior of NOx from Vehicular Traffic, Environmental Monitoring and Assessment 68-137-50, DOI 101023, A 1010730821844 PMID. Heterogeneous Catalysis, Kluwer Academic, Plenum Publishers, pp. 978-94-007-5561-1. ISSN. In Animal Evolution, Eurekalertorg, retrieved 25 October 2008. Microbiol Rev 22-5-503-521, DOI 101111, J15746976199 TB0384 XPMID.